I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Winter Haven. I'm Colin, and you're watching BDTV for Monday, April 10th, 2023. Coming up on today's show is robotics and the importance of reading.
Come on. So they had them apple bottom jean boots with the fur. The whole club was looking at her. She hit the floor. Next thing you know, so they got low, 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 low. Them baggy sweatpants and the Reeboks with the straps. She turned around and gave that big booty a slap. She hit the floor.
I'm one. Let's get into the announcements.
Students, remember to check your email every day. You may receive testing information and other important news through your school email.
The April Scholarship Bulletin is out. If you have any questions, see Mrs. Bachman.
Seniors, you are to report all offers of scholarships to Mrs. Bachman, even if you don't accept them. This is a district requirement.
There will be a senior meeting Thursday, April 13th in the auditorium third block, where your cap and gowns will be distributed.
If you haven't ordered your cap and gown, orders have a late fee of $20. In order to walk the stage at graduation, you must have a cap and gown. See Mrs. Bachman for more information.
I bet there's a lot of seniors interested in robotics.
Did you know our school has a robotics club? Robotics is a great way to expand your knowledge in the STEM field in a fun and innovative manner. I'm Colin with BDTV. Let's go learn more about robotics here at Winter Haven.
What are your favorite parts of being a part of robotics here at Winter Haven?
Well, I really like how creative the class is. We get to work with so many different things. We get to build and design robots. We get to work with 3D printers. We get to use really cool tools like this vertical belt sander. And we just get to do so much stuff with robots. And also our teacher is super cool. He lets us do so much and lets us grow in our own creative devices in the robotics area.
How long have you been a part of this school's robotics program?
1 year, but I did 3 years of robotics in Polytechnic.
Since last year.
For about 2 years, no, like 1.5 actually, because this is the middle of the second year, yeah.
I've been here for 4 years.
How do students benefit from being a part of this school's robotics program?
I think there's a lot of things that they benefit from. First is like just being able to kind of release creativity whenever they're designing robots and really using them for real life applications. So I would say just kind of that, and then also the ability to use mathematics in a real life scenario.
The robotics team at Winter Haven just completed another successful competition season. The team competed in round-robin matchups where they built models and programmed in Python. If you're interested, see Mr. Riddell in building 35208. I'm Colin with BDTV. Keep learning, Winter Haven.
Are you interested in hosting a Dutch student in October? Do you want to travel to the Netherlands for spring break next year? If so, use this QR code to fill out an application.
GradBash will have a strict dress code. Please be sure to dress appropriately. Visit GradBash on the Universal website for more information. Juan can tell us more about the dress code for GradBash.
GradBash is April 28th, and I know everybody's looking forward to it. But one thing's important. You need to remain in dress code, and I'm here to show you how. One of the most important dress code rules that we all have to follow is that there are no logos from Winter Haven High School allowed. That means no Winter Haven hoodies, no Winter Haven shirts, or shorts, or pants. Articles containing offensive material may not be worn to grad bash. No tank tops, undershirts, and sleeveless tops can be worn. And it is important that you do not show midriff or cleavage. No sagging is allowed and undergarments should not be visible. Clothing with excessive holes or shredding or clothes that show a lot of skin are not allowed to be worn. Sharp accessories such as a collar or spiked chains are not allowed to be worn as they may cause danger to other people. Dress skirt and romper hemlines may not be shorter than mid-thigh. Large backpacks or purses are not able to be brought, and same with open water bottles. So make sure you follow the dress code and have a fun time at Grad Bash, Winter Haven.
Our Aerospace Academy is doing fantastic. Last week, some members of the Blue Angels came to speak with them. Congratulations to Kami Nelson and Davey Hagelstein for being the 9th and 10th students from the Aerospace program to receive the James C. Ray Scholarship. That is huge.
The Color Guard is having an interest meeting April 26th from 2 to 4 p.m. in the band room. Join the Pride of Winter Haven as we perform our field show at football games and the Reliquist Bowl in Tampa. See Mr. Deossis for more information.
Do you think anyone on the Color Guard likes reading?
When taking a close look at Florida's testing statistics, you would be madly surprised at which the rate it's declining. But why is that? Studies prove that students that have less access to books never have time to practice reading to improve their reading level. But how can we do anything to help? I'm Kendall with BETV. Let's go find out what Winter Haven's doing. What resources does Winter Haven offer that help you excel in reading?
What helps you excel in reading is a program that we have called Books by Mail that is done by Polk County Cooperative Library, and that allows me to find any book that I'm looking for, and I can order it, and it ships to my house for free. And all I have to do to give it back is to give it to our librarian, Mrs. Moore.
If you're looking to participate in this, you must go to pclc.com and log in with your student ID, 5300, etc. Look up the book that you want and select through mail. You're a reading teacher, so why did you choose reading?
I chose reading because I see the importance of reading in our everyday lives. There's not one part of life that does not require reading at some point. My daughter, she has a home library. I order books from Scholastics. We go to the library every week. And also, we just wrote our very first book together. It's titled Clickety Clack, The Substitute is Back. The more you're around reading, the more you fall in love with it.
As you can see, Winter Haven has lots of teachers and resources that want to help you excel the best that you can. Reading is a part of everyone's day-to-day life, so make sure that you're taking advantages of the opportunities that Winter Haven is throwing at you. I'm Kendall with BETV. Go read, Winter Haven.
Any students interested in getting community service hours, volunteers are needed for Hoops Haven spring and summer basketball, camps, and clinics. See Coach Woodside for more information. Coach Woodside is the Basketball Coach of the Year. Isaac Seliskar was named Polk County Basketball Player of the Year. KJ Parker and Dylan James made All-County First Team. Congrats to you all. That's all we have for you today, Winter Haven. I'm Bella with BETV. Have a great day. And stay tuned for the Winter Haven High School alumni.
Hey, Winter Haven. Do you know who Jim Stafford is?
Well, you should. Jim Stafford is an American singer, songwriter, musician, and comedian. But what's coolest about him is that he was born and raised here in Winter Haven, Florida. When Jim Stafford was in high school, he played in a band called The Legends with Bobby Braddock, Kent Lavoie Lobo, and Graham Parsons. Stafford has had many hits in his career, with his biggest hit, Spiders and Snakes, hitting number 3 on the Billboard's Hot 100 on March 2nd, 1974. It's so awesome to see what our amazing alumni have accomplished in their lifetimes, and to know that you can too.